Hello students, today we will do chapter 13 of maths NCERT, surface areas and volumes. So in this, this we have already done in class 9th also. In that we had done basics to find the volumes and the surface areas. So mostly you will be knowing that when do we have to find the volume and when do we have to find the surface area. When they're asking anything that can be kept inside the that box or any cylinder or anything, then we have to find the volume. Means volume is anything that can be kept inside that object. And surface areas is the outer part. Suppose if I have to find the area, like the amount of the paint that will be required, or the area that I have to paint, the area that I'll have to paint the outer surface, or like the amount of paint required, the cloth needed to cover the surface. In those cases, we will find the surface area. So in class 10, mostly we have the questions related to the objects, like the combined objects. One cube is attached with a sphere, one cube is attached with a hemisphere, with a cone and a cylinder. So we have to mostly find the surface areas or the volumes of the combined objects, or you can say joined objects. So first we will read about all the basic formulas, like whatever we need in this chapter. We'll go through, we'll have a quick revision of all the formulas once, and then we will start with the questions of NCERT textbook. So let's start with the first one, that is cuboid. Before starting with the formulas, I just want you to know that when we have to find the volume, so volume is basically the area into height. I'm not saying that we have to just write the area and height, but it is the basic concept of area into height. Area of the base shape of that 3D shape. Like suppose if it is a cuboid, so the basic shape of the cuboid is a rectangle. So we will write the area of the rectangle. So volume of cuboid will be area of the rectangle, that is L into B, and then we'll multiply it with height. So we'll get the volume of cuboid. It is easier to learn in this way. Volume is always the area of the basic shape into height. Then about the lateral surface area. Lateral surface area is area of four walls, or area around the, of area of around, surroundings like that. We don't include the base and the base and the top. We don't include that. We just take the area of the four walls. So lateral surface area of a cuboid means the area of four walls of the cuboid. If you say consider a room, then the walls, the four walls which stand like this, the area of that. So basically the lateral surface area is perimeter of the base shape into height. The perimeter of rectangle is 2L plus B multiplied by height. So this is the lateral surface area of a cuboid. Total surface area is lateral surface area plus the area of the base and plus the area of the top. So I'll write in that way only, 2L plus B into H plus area of the base will be L into B plus area of the top, that will also be L into B. When we will solve this, we'll get Y is length into breadth plus breadth into height plus length into height. So this is the total surface area of a cuboid. So it is basically what, like when we take the four walls, so the when we take the floor, so floor is having length and the breadth, and the wall which is standing, that is the height. So if we consider the floor, that is a rectangle, and the area of the floor is length into breadth. And if we consider one wall, that is length into height, the adjacent wall is breadth into height. So there are two area, like floor and ceiling will be same. Two opposite walls will be have same area, and two like this walls will be have same area. So that is why we are multiplying length breadth plus breadth height plus length height by two, because total we have six walls in a cuboid. Sometimes the questions are like that. They ask us to find the area, or like the paint will be required for that area that we have to paint. So basically we don't paint the floors. We paint only the four walls of the room, and the ceiling. So when they're asking like questions around whitewashing or painting or coloring of anything like that, so what we do, we just find the lateral surface area, means the area of the four walls, and we find the area of the ceiling, that is length into breadth. So most of the students, what they do, they find the total surface area and then they subtract the area of the ceiling. So it's better that you find the lateral surface area and you add the area of the ceiling. So that will be easier. Now let's move towards the cube. Same way we will do for cube. The basic shape is square. So the volume will be, and in this all the sides are equal. So the height is also L. So the area of the square is L square multiplied by L, that is L cube. Or you can write side cube. The volume of cube is side cube. Lateral surface area means area of the four walls. As all the sides are equal, so one area of one side will be L squared. So in lateral surface area, we take the area of four walls. So it is 4L squared. In total surface area, it is area of six walls. So it is 6L squared. So this is about the cube. Next, move towards the cylinder. The basic shape of cylinder, or you can say the base of the cylinder is a circle. So we will generate all the formulas based on the circle. First, volume. Volume will be area of the circle into height. So pi r square is the area of the circle multiplied by height. The volume of cylinder is pi r square h, where r is the radius of the cylinder and h is the height of the cylinder. And pi, as we all know, its value is equal to 22/7, or somewhere if it is mentioned, we use 3.14 also. And then, since cylinder is not like, it's not having straight surfaces, it has a curved surface. So instead of lateral surface area, we use curved surface area. And same curved surface area will be perimeter of the cylinder, that is circumference of the circle, circumference of the circle multiplied by height. The circumference of the circle is 2 pi r and multiplied by height. So curved surface area of a cylinder is 2 pi r h. Then total surface area is curved surface area plus area of base and area of top. So curved surface area is 2 pi r h. So area of the base will be pi r squared. Area of top is again a circle. So it will be pi r squared. So it is 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r squared. If we take 2 pi r common, we will be left with 2 pi r h plus r. You can use this formula also. You can use it in this way also. Whatever is easier for you to memorize. Okay. So next is cone. So cone, volume is, in this we will not take that area into height. In this it is actually 1/3 of the cylinder. So it is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Means if it is, if there is any cylinder like this, so this is the radius, this is the radius, and this is the height of the cylinder. So if we cut out the cone, if we have to cut out a cone out of this cylinder, we can cut three cones out of it. So that is why it is actually 1/3 of the cylinder. So you can see there are three cones, we can take it out. 1, 2, and 3. So it is 1/3 of the cylinder. And in the cone, we have to take this height also. This height is called a slant height. And that we denote as L. So curved surface area of the cone is pi r L, and actually cone is always a right angle triangle. So L is equals to root square, root under h square plus r square. H is the height, r is the radius. Total surface area will be, curved surface area plus the area of the base. In this case, we, the top is the pointed one, so we don't take the area of the top. In this, only area of the base will be taken. So pi r l plus pi r square. If we take pi and r common, it will be l plus r. So this is the total surface area of the cone. Next comes the sphere. For sphere, the volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube. R is the radius of the sphere. And in the sphere, actually, we don't have curved surface area or total surface area because it is a complete circular thing. So yeah, we cannot consider what is the like four sides, what is the six sides. It is completely a single, like a completely circular thing. So in this, we take only the surface area. That is, that means total surface area only, and that equals 4 pi r square. Means we have to take, we need four circles to make one sphere. That is why it is the four times the area of one circle. I'll write hemisphere here only to make you that will be easier for you to relate and then memorize. In this, the hemisphere is half of the sphere. The volume will be half of it. It will be 2 by 3 pi r cube. In this, we have curved surface area because the shape of the sphere is like this. This hemisphere is this. This is the top part and this is the curved part. So in the curved surface area, we consider only this part. So the curved surface area of hemisphere is 2 pi r square. Means we take, for total surface of a sphere, we'll be needing four circles. So curved surface area of a hemisphere will be needing only two circles, so 2 pi r square. And total surface area of a hemisphere will be, this, in this we are needing two, and this is one circle. The top is one circle. So it will be 3 pi r square. So we can memorize like this also. Curved surface area will start from hemisphere. Curved surface area 2 pi r square. Total surface area 3 pi r square. And surface area of sphere is 4 pi r square. One more shape is there in class 10, that is frustum of a cone. That we will do later when we will be solving the exercise of the frustum of a cone. Then that time we will do the frustum, all the formulas of the frustum of a cone.